dipshit.
Oh, it's a camera here. I'm gonna say something funny.
Lee will fuck you up if you talk any more shit.
He doesn't like you.
This reminds me of my high school years. Standing around all the kids while they're all conversating, having a good time, and I'm here all alone.
Anybody want an autograph?
I always pictured it would be a lot more fun and entertaining, and I would always picture myself doing fun shit, but turns out I'm just a fucking loser. I'm sure if you guys had to pick just by the name Funny Man would have seemed pretty appealing. You know that you'd be walking around laughing, the camera would be shaking, you'd have to put on image stabilizer because you'd be giggling so hard, you would shake the camera. Plus the footage would be unusable.
Look at that fucking idiot! Get out of here, you dumbass!
Where?
Oh, that guy just walked by?
Who has to follow him around? Sucks off. You're texting your buddies right now like, dude, worst day ever. I'll tell you later. Meet me at the bar.
Which bar are you going to?
I'm not inviting you, I'm talking to buddies.
Hey, what bar are you going to?
Hey, oh, yeah.
Who's following him around, dude? Whoever's following him around probably got a hard on.
Hey, bro, how do you eat your corn? Around the world or typewriter?
Oh. Dylan, hurry the fuck up!
I'm getting ready, motherfucker!
Is this cello enough?
Maybe some more writing. Charlie's seen over there acting like...
What's some of your favorite recording software to use?
Pro Tools and Cubase are the only things we use at all. Like, he has Cubase, and I don't think he really knows how to use it. He just presses buttons.
We be clubbing!
What's something you always wanted to learn but never got the opportunity?
To beat Charlie Sheen's ass.
Yeah, it's like me, I got the opportunity to do that, so I moved on. But something I'd say the violin or some kind of other instrument that's hard to play.
Beating Charlie Sheen's ass is kind of like an instrument in itself.
I perfected that one already.
No one in the world knows how to beat Charlie.
Yeah. What's up?
All right, is there anything you guys want to say to your fans?
I love you. Yay, West Side.
Yeah, he literally, in movie theaters, when a horror thing comes on, he plugs his ears and goes, num, 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 num. He literally does that. Oh, Fire in the Sky.
Fire in the Sky.
That's not really a horror movie.
Yeah, but that movie scares the... It's still scary. It's
just I found Jay. I was like, where's Funny? And he's like, oh, he's in his room. He just ate a bunch of shrooms. He was watching Fire in the Sky. I was like... Fucking weirdo.
Yeah. I came back and he was just like, his skin was all pale and just like, could that really happen?
Started to go looking out the window.
Yeah, the sky. Have you ever seen that golf movie with Big Boy from Outkast called Who's Your Caddy?
That one sounds pretty scary.
That's a horror movie. In my opinion. No offense.
Which Hitchcock movies do you like?
I like Birds. I just think it's funny. Cause you know, it's like one of those movies you watch, you're like, dude, if I was there, I'd be like smacking those birds, I'd be breaking their beaks. Cause you're like, why are you running from a bunch of birds? So it's just one of those movies you can't help but watch and you just like really get into it. They're in the Hollywood, they have a cemetery on Saturdays during the summer at night. They play like horror movies and we used to go there and just get shit faced and yell at the screen. And I'm like,
yeah, and all the hipster people would be getting pissed at us. Yeah, they're like, we just want to watch the movie, and we'd be like drunk as fuck, like pissing on people's graves. I never put
chased. Remember I got chased out by the security guards and golf course.
Yeah. And then like get on my board and skate around behind tombstones.
Tell when you yelled at Corey Hart or whatever.
Oh, Carey Hart, the dude when he did the backflip.
That's married to Pink.
Yeah.
No, he was walking down the street and he's like, yo, Corey, do a backflip, motherfucker. And you could just see him like get so pissed off.
And we saw him again inside the cemetery, like within a sea of people. Hey, Corey, do a backflip, boom.
And we just like dug down in the crowd.
And he got kicked out by security. He was like hiding behind tombstones, like with his skateboard, like running around.
I didn't get kicked out. I just was getting chased because I was on my skateboard. Yeah. Quit disturbing the peace, man.
Hi, I'm Charlie Sheen.
I'm Johnny Three Tears.
And we're from
Hollywood Undead.
And musicuniverse.net is the best website in the universe.net.
Yep.
Deuce, last year, did an interview with us, and he said that he was the soul of the band, and that you guys couldn't write any songs without him. But obviously, two albums later,
yeah,
you've proven him wrong. But what do you think about him saying that?
Well, I'm used to him being a moron.
It's not, yeah.
Well, it doesn't surprise me.
Exactly.
The guy's a dipshit.
That's
so
why he's not in the band anymore, because he says stuff like that, egomaniac stuff like that, man. That's why I got rid of the guy.
So you're, not or, well, you're not surprised.
Old news, but yeah, we're not surprised. He says retarded shit all the time, so.
I'm starting to wonder if he is retarded.
He is, I think, partially.
Next single video you said for Another Way Out, correct? Yeah. Do you have any hints on what it will be, or is it a big secret?
The video is going to be directed by Charlie Scene.
Good.
Yeah, he's a good director. He's a really good guy. He's a cool guy to be around. He's fun. He's funny. He's charming.
We call him Charlie Spielberg. He's so good.
Yeah, it's like a young Spielberg, and he's doing the video. He's directing the video. I don't know how
we got
him.
This guy's offended by that. He doesn't think you even know how to work a camera, bro.
No, I know how to work that thing. We get such a good reaction. We played all those festivals, and it's really something magical about this this place that we're in now.
So happy.
I'm not happy right now.
Oh, oops.
<I'm sad. laughs>
We're having fun.
It's the European vibe. It gets very free with his sexuality.
I do. Maybe you can do the Snoop Dogg song. Trent can produce it. Snoop Dogg.
I heard they're beefing. Trent and Snoop. They're not getting along.
I can get them.
You can settle them
down. Yeah, look how affectionate I am. I would just hug both of them like this. I'd give him a kiss, I guess. I heard him in his bunk last night singing some One Direction stuff too. So I don't know if he's trying to keep that a secret or.
We call him One Erection.
Yeah, he calls it One Erection because he masturbates to it in his bunk.
Yeah. Just their voices intoxicate me.
Guys make them or you have them?
We design them.
We design them, yeah.
Yeah, then we have someone else make them. We're not going to do that kind
of work. I couldn't put an IKEA piece of furniture together. You think I can make a mask?
My latest mask has, like, gas mask canisters on it. I used to collect, like, World War I, II gas masks. I used to be fascinated with war history. So, I don't know, that's recently. It's fun to change it up every album because you kind of get bored with the same thing, so you just switch it up. I don't know what I'm going to do next time. Put a big-ass unicorn horn on it or something.
He's into fantasy.
Oh, yeah, you should totally do that.
Yeah, I'm getting really into fantasy, Game of Thrones, all that stuff.
So, like, is there any artists you'd like to collaborate with in the future?
Our music is so pocketed that I don't think there's any bands really like us. So it kind of makes it difficult because how can you include someone in it and make sense of it? So it's never been really done. I mean, Snoop Dogg was one that came up once, and then it's like, well, you know, that would make sense, but we can't afford him. We can't afford Snoop Lion.
Yeah, I'm Johnny.
I'm Johnny Cash.
We're Hollywood Undead.
Undead? We always start off with Undead. That gets the crowd ready. I think just basically all of our singles are the big ones. Young, Everywhere I Go, Coming in Hot. We should play that song twice.
Yeah, we space them out. We'll go on the road for 2 months, 2 weeks off or whatever, go somewhere else. So they space it out, so we have a little time at home, you know, to eat Cheetos and game it.
We're gonna keep eating Cheetos, playing Modern Warfare.
No, we're switching to Cheetos Puffs.
Oh, yeah. We usually eat the Flamin' Hots. We're gonna go with Cheetos Puffs. And then we're gonna start writing the third record as soon as we're out of Cheetos.
There's gonna be Cheetos on all the keys of the people.
Yeah, maybe we have orange keys.
I mean, something always happens. The other night, Eric, he's our monitor guy, he thought the back lounge was the bathroom. And someone actually sleeps back there.
Yeah.
And he just started pissing all over the place.
He pissed all over our merch guy.
And he got upset.
Yeah. We don't like our merch guy, so we gave him a raise.
Yeah, he thought he was going to get in trouble.
Yeah.
Like, that's $200 more a week for you for pissing on that dude. Yeah.
Levitate is the current single.
Probably going to be very uncurrent soon, though. It sucks. I'm just kidding. No, I like that single.
No, it's good. It might be Coming in Hot out here, though. That's what I heard, right? Yeah, out here, the single's Coming in Hot, and it's Coming in Hot.
No.
We're going to play it twice, I think, tonight. Thank you. This is our biggest show to date that we've played as a headliner. This is our biggest show, so thank you very much for that. We're very excited about that. And so was my bank account. I'm just kidding. We're so poor. Can I borrow $20?